Okay, welcome to ECO 501, Section 2, Week 4, Fall 2021 semester. So today what we'll do, we'll revisit some basic concepts that we learned in high school, which include how to read a graph and how to interpret ratios. Now, these things are very simple. Some of you have done it and you will find it so elementary that today's class will be a wastage of time. But some people, for some people, you see, mathematics is a trash, and it gives you nightmares. So that's why we want to just clarify a few concepts. So let me get the. Can you see the slides?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, sir. Information. This slide is already available in the Google Drive. Because you are section 2, after section 1's class on Saturday, I uploaded in the Google Drive. So you can find it there. Acha. This week, these are the three topics that we are going to, four topics. How to read a graph. What do we mean by a slope? A slope is basically a ratio. So how do we interpret a ratio? Then we give a introduction to demand and supply. Now, I assume that most of you in your section has done an elementary economics course in the undergrad, right? Most of you.
Yes, sir.
Because if you are coming from a business background, you definitely have done a basic micro course in the undergrad. If you are coming from an economics background, definitely you have. Even if you are coming from an engineering background, you will probably have done a basic economics course. So what you will see today is basically things that you have done before. And then before we finish, we just give a brief briefing of what topics we will cover the following week. The references are from Stiglitz and Walsh and McGuigan et al. In the slides, I'll get the page numbers will be there. So you can access the page numbers and the particular part of that reference from the PDF. Okay. Now, the reading graphs, we are looking from Stiglitz and Walsh, page numbers 47 and 50. You can look at it something else as well. Acha. Basically, what is a graph? Number one, what is the advantage of using a graph in economics or economic analysis? Now, from high school mathematics, we know that, what do you call it? A graph is nothing but a two-dimensional relationship, right? Why do we call it a two-dimensional relationship? Because it has two axes. This is the vertical axis and this is the horizontal axis. So based on these two axes, we plot various points and then we see whether there's a trend in the point, in the series of points. Are they downward sloping? Are they upward sloping? Or is there no trend at all? Basically, when we plot some points in a graph, are the points sloping upwards? Are the points sloping downwards? Or is there no pattern at all? Isn't this what we try to see when we plot points in a graph?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The reason why I'm asking this question is that if we see there's a upward relationship, we then can find a cause and effect. If we see there's a downward relationship, we can also find a cause and effect. If we see a parallel relationship, we can also find a cause and effect. But if the points are plotted with no distinctive pattern, then we can't find a cause and effect. Why is this necessary? This is necessary because in economics, we are obsessed by cause and effect. Price changes first, then quantity demanded response or quantity supplied response. In order to establish this relationship, we need a cause and effect. That means if we want to visually show this cause and effect, we have to go to graphs. Acha. Is there anybody in this class who can tell me what an independent variable is and what a dependent variable is? If you've forgotten, no problem, I'll remind you. Is there anybody in the class who can tell me what an independent variable is and what a dependent variable is? Nobody in the class? Or everybody has forgotten? Kunta?
Kind of forgot.
Okay, no problem. Independent variable, two events will happen one after another. Okay, so this is event one, this is event two. This is the first condition for independent and dependent. The independent variable is the one that happens first. The dependent variable is the one that happens after the independent variable and because of the independent variable. Ei duta condition fulfill hote hobe. Number one, the dependent variable happens after the independent variable and because of the independent variable. Now, do we have any foreign people in the class today? Any non-Bangladeshis? Do we have any non-Bangladeshis? Tale ki majhe majhe ki bangla bolbo?
Yes sir.
Acha jodi if you find my English you know not you can't follow it amake bolo ami bangla bolbo tale thik ache. Otherwise most of the times we'll speak in English. I think we don't have any foreign friends in the class. Okay. So the objective is ekta duita ghotona kintu age piche ghortei pare. For example, let me give you a classic example. Your friend enters the room and then Taskin gets a wicket, which he did today. Okay, can we say that because your friend entered the room, thus Taskin got a wicket?
No sir.
Sorry, is this one kind of
sir.
Random events. Just because two events happen one after another, they don't qualify as independent and dependent. But independent will always happen first. Dependent will happen after the independent variable, and because of the dependency, it happens because of the independent variable. Okay, so your friend entered the class room, and the moment he entered the room, Taskin got a wicket. So this is not independent or dependent; they are randomly done. But if we make a hypothesis, if the price of something increases, then demand and supply will change. We can say that these are independent and dependent variables, can't we?
Yes sir.
Because if the price had not changed over time, then probably people's demand for a particular commodity, people's supply for a particular commodity would have remained unchanged. Because the price has changed and the whole information has gone into the market, people respond differently. Theek ache, so the first thing is, in economics we are obsessed with cause and effect. This was one of the reasons why for the Nobel Prize in economics this year. So and but in order to do that, we need to be sure that two events don't happen randomly. If they happen randomly, we may say that there is a correlation between them. We'll give you an example today. If not, then we can establish yes, there's a cause and effect, thus we can model this particular phenomenon. So when we are looking at a graph, what we are doing, we are interested in the graph because it's two dimensional. What's the advantage of having two dimensional? There's two variables. One of them will be the dependent and one of them will be the independent. So this relationship may be functional, which we will see. If it's not functional, it may be correlated. Okay. Now, those of you who have come from a mathematics background, okay, or have a good mathematical background, we all know that by definition, the horizontal axis is always the independent variable, right? Na? X-axis.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
And the y-axis, by definition or convention, is always the dependent variable, right?
Yes, sir.
How do we understand that? Because when we present a function, we write it as y is equal to function of x. তখন আমরা কিভাবে পড়ি? X, any variable on the right side of the equation, by convention, is independent. Any variable on the left side of the equation, by convention, is the dependent variable. আচ্ছা এখন আমি যদি লিখতাম X is a function of y, what will you understand? Y is the independent variable, right?
Yes, sir.
x is a function of y. ঠিক আছে মানে x is equal to function of y. Then since I know that all the variables on the right side are the independent variable, and since somebody has written x is equal to function of y, so y is the independent variable, and x now becomes the dependent variable. Is it not possible to write like this? এটা লিখতে পারি না আমরা?
Yes, sir.
Definitely we can. And some of you might be uncomfortable because from childhood, the moment you saw a graph, the teachers have said x is always the independent variable, y is the dependent variable. This is the mathematical convention. In economics, there was an economist called Alfred Marshall in the 1890s when he introduced these graphs in economics. What he did, he made y the independent variable, price, and quantity the dependent variable. I'll repeat this two more times. In mathematics, by convention, x is always the independent variable, y is the dependent variable. That's why we write y is a function of x. Alfred Marshall in the 1890s, he reversed this convention. What he did, he was a mathematician himself, but what he did, he put price on the vertical axis and quantity demanded or quantity supplied on the horizontal axis. Now, picture when we write quantity demanded is a function of price. আমরা এভাবে লিখি না? Have you ever seen price is a function of quantity?
স্যার ইকোনমিক্স এর কোন একটা কোর্স আমরা দেখেছিলাম রিভার্স এর কিছু
আচ্ছা হু সেড দ্যাট
স্যার ইটস অরিশনা
অরিশনা অরিশনা ইজ ইওর ব্যাকগ্রাউন্ড ফ্রম ইকোনমিক্স
নো স্যার ইটস আই হ্যাভ ডান অ্যান কোর্স ইন ইকোনমিক্স Like it was macro, I guess, micro or macro.
Okay, no problem. I'll answer your question, but remind me at the end of the today's discussion. Okay.
Yes, sir.
It is possible. I'll tell you at the end of the discussion. The thing is, when we write quantity demanded is a function of price, by definition, we know that price is the independent variable because it's on the right side of the equation. Quantity demanded or quantity supplied of x is the dependent variable, which is on the left side of the equation. But when we plot it on the graph, isn't price on the vertical axis?
Yes, sir.
That means that's where the independent variable is. Isn't quantity always on the horizontal axis?
Yes, sir.
So that's where the dependent variable is. So once we introduce the concept of slope, whatever slope calculation we get with mathematics, economics er thik ulta jabe na, won't it become inverted?
Yes, sir.
In mathematics, we know del y by del x is the what? That's the slope, right? Del y by del x slope, jani na amra?
Yes, sir. Del y by del x.
Del x. This is a mathematical convention. But the moment we do it in economics, it becomes del x by del y. Because the vertical axis is on the y is the independent variable, so it will become del x by del y. So whatever calculation we get with mathematics, suppose our mathematics amra 90 degree ekta ye jokhon dekhi tokhon amra boli na eta slope hocche infinity. If we see a straight line on the x axis totally perpendicular, don't we say that the slope is 90 degree?
Yes, sir.
Why do we say the slope is 90 degree? Because it creates 90 degree to the independent axis. What is the independent axis? The independent axis is the x axis. Ekhon ami jodi boli the y is the independent axis, can you picture that that same line is making a 0 degree with the y axis?
Yes, sir.
That means in economics, that same line which we defined as 90 degree for mathematics becomes 0 degree for economics, and the slope becomes 0. Clear?
Sir, it will be easier for us if you show us any picture or graph.
I will show it in the graph. The thing is, if you can visualize it, then the pura clear ho jabe, ha? Okay. Now I'm definitely going to show it to you. So basically, where are we? So causation, we said that by definition, always y is equal to function of x means x is the independent variable, the variable that happens first. Y is the dependent variable, the variable that happens after x and because of x, aj. This is the condition for a functional relationship. The second event happens after the first event and because of the first event. Acha, this one we have said that price changes first, then and because of price change, quantity demanded or quantity supply changes. This is not a random event. So we can say that this is a functional relationship between these two. Acha, eta ekta amra bolchi, a guest comes to the house, your team wins a match. That happens later. Just because the guest came to the house does not mean that your team won the match. These two events are totally random. So the after clause is applicable, but not the because of. Acha, eitate bolo to, can we establish a functional relationship? Read the sentence. Do children of professionals and high income parents get better jobs?
Do children
of professionals, your children of high paid bureaucrats, high paid business executives, high paid doctors, okay, do their children get better jobs?
Sorry, it depends on children qualification.
This question on its own is very difficult to establish a functional relationship, right?
Yes, sir.
Right, sir.
For example, with price and quantity demanded or quantity supplied, we could just say that, yes, if price goes up and down, quantity demanded and supply will change. But in the context of that particular question, do the children of professionals and high income people get better jobs? May or may not. This is called correlation. Do you get the logic now?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Yes, sir. Got the logic.
If we can establish a functional relationship, second event happened after the first and because of the first, then number is a y is equal to function of x, quantity demanded is a function of price, whether x or y is the independent variable, that doesn't matter. The thing is, we can establish a cause and effect. With this particular question, depending on the particular data set, one researcher might say there's a functional relationship, another researcher might say that it's not a functional relationship. So that's why we call this correlation. For example, in the have you noticed that if something bad happens to the American economy, the stock market falls?
Yes, sir. Seen that.
And what happens to the American economy? The stock market rises, right?
Right.
Yeah. If you follow the media, the American media especially, but the American media is obsessed that if something bad happens, then stock markets fall. Can we establish that a random effect happened and the stock affected the stock markets? এটা বলা যায় না. These events are so random that actually we can say there's a correlation, but we cannot say that there's cause and effect. Ever clear? Huh?
Sir, arekbar ektu bolte hobe.
Abar boli tale. Look at this question. Can you establish a cause and effect? Because my father is rich, because my father is a high professional, thus I get a better job. Can you establish a cause and effect?
Not all the time, no.
All the time, sometimes maybe, other times not.
Yes, sir.
This is an example of correlation.
Yes, sir.
Just example here. Yes, there's a definite cause and effect relationship. This one is totally random. Second one, the third one, it may or may not be true. So maybe in one researcher's data set, yes, it's true. In another researcher's data set, it may not be true. So these type of relationships we define as correlation. ঠিক আছে? Okay? আচ্ছা এখন দেখ what we are going to say is causation expressed as functions. A quantity demanded is a function of price. So we know by definition price is the independent variable. Quantity demanded or quantity supplied is the dependent variable. Now visualize. When we plot this relationship in a graph, don't we always put price on the vertical axis?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Tara mathematics theke asche othoba jader mathematical background ektu better. Don't you find this a little bit confusing? Just throughout my whole life, I know that x is the independent variable, independent axis. Sorry, if we plot price on the vertical axis, the independent axis, the vertical axis, where jacche na? How many of you find this a bit confusing? Wow, tumake harai gela naki abar?
Yes, sir. We are here.
Oh, you are here. But do you find it a little bit confusing now? Now that I've mentioned it.
Actually, no, sir. No, sir.
Kind of easy to remember because whatever happens in math, it's the opposite here in economics.
That's it. So, who said? Who made this observation?
Kazi Soban.
So, whatever ratio you find in mathematics, you just invert it. And you get it, you get the economics ratio. This is a rule of thumb we'll remember, huh? So, এখন এটা কি দেখানো দরকার আছে? This is the origin, and this is the coordinates. This is minus 3x plus 1y. এগুলো দেখানো দরকার আছে?
No, sir.
You don't see that, but what we need to show is that the first quadrant is the only quadrant that we are interested in economics. The answer is very simple. Price may fall, but can price ever be negative?
No.
Quantity may reduce, okay, for whatever reason, but can quantity ever be negative?
No, sir.
So that's why in mathematics, we can find x and y's values and negative, but all the economic variables that we are going to plot on a graph, there are one or two very noble exceptions, but 99% of the times, none of the variables value will ever be less than zero. That's why when we plot a graph in economics, we concentrate only on the first quadrant, never on the second, third, or fourth quadrant. Okay? Okay. We will focus only on the first quadrant because in economics, we never find a negative value. আচ্ছা এটা দাঁড়াও ওয়েট লেট মি জাস্ট সি ওয়ান থিং ডিভিডি ইজ অন দ্য এক্স ওকে দিস ইজ অলসো ফ্রম হোয়াট ইউ কল ইট স্টিগলিস এন্ড ওয়ালশ পেজ নাম্বারটা দেওয়া আছে ও দ্য টেবিল নাম্বার ইজ গিভেন টেবিল 2.1 সো ওভার হিয়ার উই হ্যাভ আ টেবিল ওকে নাও বিফোর উই গেট ইনটু দ্য গ্রাফ ক্যান ইউ ভিজুয়ালাইজ দিস টেবিল ডিভিডি ইজ অন দ্য এক্স অ্যাক্সিস আচ্ছা আমি একটা কাজ করি This is x axis, this is y axis. Okay. DVDs are on the x axis, CDs are on the y axis. What type of a relationship do you observe if I plot it in a graph? Is it a downward sloping relationship? Is it an upward sloping relationship? Or is it no relationship at all?
Sir, it's upward actually. I'm saying correctly.
Like a downward one.
Achha, who said upward?
Sir, me, Rohan.
Okay, let's see. Let me show that you're
no,
not.
No, sir, it's downward. Maybe it's downward.
Okay, now you tell me why you thought. Now, why do you see it's downward now?
Yeah, because the x-axis is higher and comes to lower at the same stage where the y-axis is coming from lower to higher.
Yeah. If we look at the DVDs, which are the x, the values are falling. Correspondingly, the values of y are rising, right? Over here?
Yes, sir.
x is falling, and as the value of x is falling, each corresponding value of y is increasing. So this is definitely a negative relationship. A negative relationship means when we plot a graph or a straight line, it will be downward sloping. Acha, this is one observation that we make. We make another observation. Can anybody find a definite ratio between x and y? If I increase x by one unit, does y decrease by a certain unit all the time? If I decrease x over here,
sir, by two units.
Y is always increasing by 2 units, right?
Yes.
5 to 4, 2 to 4, 2 units increases. 4 to 3 on x, y increases by 4 to 6, 2 units. 3 to 2, x decreases by 1 unit, y increases by 2 units, right?
Yes, sir.
So, can you visualize a ratio that the change in x is always 1 unit and the corresponding change in y is always 2 units? Can you visualize a ratio like this?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
Everybody visualize it before we get into the graph, because Mr. Jobair, are you following us?
Yes, sir.
So can you visualize it? Because you asked me that you need to see it in a graph. Can you visualize it? Then we get into
yes,
the graph.
Sir, I visualized. Yes, sir. So I already answered that there is a 2 unit change every time.
Okay. That means you visualized it by now. Has anybody else also visualized? Look, if the y changes by 1 unit, sorry, x changes by 1 unit, y changes by 2 units. এটা প্রতিটা পদে পদে কি দেখতে পাচ্ছে সবাই?
Yes.
Y changes from 5 to 4. That means it falls by 1 unit. Y increases by 2 units from 2 to 4. X changes from 4 to 3. It reduces by 1 unit. Y correspondingly increases by 2 units from 4 to 6. So the change in X and the change in Y is very well defined. What is the ratio? It is either 2 or half. Taya? Who's crying? So when we if we present this as a ratio, the ratio will be either 1 by 2 or 2 by 1.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now we are going to present it in a graph, but we are going to follow the mathematical convention. If we follow the mathematical convention, what do we know? The slope will be del y by del x. Why? Because y is the dependent variable, which will always be on the top as the numerator. X is the independent variable, which will always be at the bottom as the denominator. Keno hobe seta amra pore bolbo, but let's see the edge. This is the slope. Rise by run. Rise mane ki? Aren't we moving on the vertical axis? If I say something is rising or falling, then automatically we are making a vertical movement, right? If I say something is rising or falling, aren't we making a vertical movement visually?
Yes, sir. Normally, yeah.
Yes, sir.
When we present a slope with the mathematics convention as del y on the top, we are moving on the vertical axis on the numerator. That's why we're using the word rise. And when we use the word rise, we are focusing on the vertical axis. Acha, amra jokhon run kori, aren't we running horizontally from left to right or right to left?
Yes, sir.
I say that if you're on the street, you see somebody running on the opposite side of the road. The person may be running from left to right or right to left, but that person is definitely running horizontally, right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So when we are following the mathematical convention, del x is at the bottom, so it must be the horizontal axis. That's why we say run. So the ratio is nothing but the change in the dependent variable with respect to the change in the independent variable, which in this case is x. That's why the ratio over here is rise by run, which because as we move from A to E, x increases from 2 to 3, so the run is positive. Y decreases from 8 to 6, so the rise is negative, so the ratio becomes minus 2. Now, let me stop it. If I said that Y is the independent variable like price, and X is the dependent variable like quantity, তাহলে আমাদের ratio যদি slopeটা calculate করতাম, ঠিক oppositeটা হবে না? Will it be minus 2 or will it be minus half? Price becomes the independent variable. Quantity becomes a dependent variable. তাহলে ratioটা কি হবে? Del x by del y হবে না? If we want to calculate the slope.
Yes, sir.
Okay. তাহলে the mathematical slope that we just found out now to be minus 2, সেটা economic slope কি হবে? Minus half হবে না?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now let us go back and look at it again visually. AJ, this is the mathematical calculation. So we calculated rise by run. Why? Del y is the dependent, del x is the independent. Del x is horizontal, so it's run. Del y is vertical, so it's rise. Kintu eta jodi amra bolten je this is an economics convention, then what would have happened? We would have written it as run by rise. তাহলে কি মাইনাস টু টা মাইনাস হাফ হয়ে যাবে না?
Yes, sir.
এবার ক্লিয়ার হয়েছে?
Yes,
sir. Now, okay. এই যে ম্যাথমেটিক্স কনভেনশন, x is always the independent variable, y is the dependent variable. This is a mathematical convention from the times of ancient Babylon, today's Iran and Iraq. But in economics, Mr. Alfred Marshall in 1890s, he changed the convention by putting price on the vertical axis. So economics convention might change. Change kichui hobe na, everything will be inverse. So whatever calculation you get in mathematics as minus 2 will become minus half. That's the only difference. Okay. So the mathematical convention, horizontal axis x is the independent variable, we get the slope as this, plus 2. Economics convention, vertical axis is the independent variable. So del y by del x is no longer the slope. The slope becomes del x by del y. Just the inverse. So the slope becomes half. Ever clear?
Yes, sir.
Lovely. Okay, so egli ta amader ar dekhano dorkar nei tale. Acha. Acha, how do we interpret a ratio? A ratio can have not more than three distinct values. Why? If we define the ratio as del y by del x, what is the relationship between del y and del x? If del y is greater than del x, the ratio must be greater than 1. Can you visualize it? If del y by del x is the ratio, and if del y is greater than del x, won't the ratio be greater than 1?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is one possibility. Second possibility is del y and del x are equal to each other. Then what will the ratio be?
1.
Okay.
The other last possibility is del y is less than del x. Then the ratio can be less than 1, right?
Yes, sir.
So when we want to find out what is the value of a ratio? Common sense tells us it cannot be more than three numbers, because we are comparing del y with del x, the values. So when we compare, one can be greater than the other, one can be equal to the other, one can be less than the other. Er baire ki ar kono logical possibility ache? Are there any other logical possibilities outside these three possibilities?
No, sir. Visibly not.
It are possible now. So we have exhausted, and common sense just tells us del y by del del y greater than del x greater than 1, del y equal to del x equal to 1, del y less than del x less than 1. So eglu interpretation amra next class e korbo, but এর বাইরে তো আর হবে না, এর বাইরে আর হবে? ওকে, নাও দ্য নেক্সট কোয়েশ্চেন ইজ, ওয়েন সামথিং ইজ গ্রেটার দেন ওয়ান, হাউ মাচ গ্রেটার ক্যান ইট বি? এই প্রশ্নটা আসে। So if del y by del x is greater than 1, what is the value? Is it plus 1? Is it plus 2? Is it plus 3? Is it plus 4? Maximum
infinity.
Who said infinity?
Sir, Samia, sir.
Samia. Tamane del y by del x jodi greater than 1 hoy, the maxim the limit is infinity. Er baire ar jabe na, right?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, if del y by del x, if this ratio is less than 1, what is the limit? কত ছোট পর্যন্ত হতে পারবে?
Minus infinity.
Minus infinity. If it can be zero. Del y is less than del x. We are not using signs. আমরা কি signs use করেছি?
No, sir.
So if we don't use signs, plus or negative, then we calculate in absolute terms. Okay. So if we calculate in absolute terms and we say that del y is less than del x, কত কত কম পর্যন্ত হতে পারবে? ক্যান ইট বি লেস দেন জিরো?
অ্যাবসলিউট হলে তো জিরোর নিচে
আসবে না, জিরোর নিচে
আসবে। দ্যাট মিন্স উই হ্যাভ ক্যালকুলেটেড দ্য টু এক্সট্রিমস। ইফ ডেল ওয়াই ইজ গ্রেটার দেন ডেল এক্স, রেশিও ইজ গ্রেটার দেন ওয়ান, দ্য ম্যাক্সিমাম লিমিট ক্যান বি ইনফিনিটি। দ্য আদার এক্সট্রিম ইজ ডেল ওয়াই ইজ লেস দেন ডেল এক্স, ইজ লেস দেন ওয়ান, so the other extreme is zero. So these are the five values that ratios can take. Either is greater than one, the limit being infinity, or it is less than one, the limit being zero, and coincidentally it can be equal to one if del y and del x are equal to each other. Tana, is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Okay, now we go back to, if you don't follow AJ, here it is, the values of the ratio, what is the relationship between del y and del x? Jokhoni amra ei shobdota bolbo, we are comparing del y with del x. The moment we compare del y with del x, we want to see which one is larger, which one is smaller. So there can be only three logical values. Del y by del x are equal to each other, so there it will be one, the ratio. Del y greater than del x, so ratio will be greater than one. Del y less than del x, so ratio will be less than one. So then the next question that we ask is, when it is greater than one, how much greater can it be? We have all agreed that it can be infinity. If it is less than one, what is, how small can it be? We have all visualized that it will be zero, right? Yes?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I'm going to challenge some of you in mathematics. Huh? It's very simple, nothing to worry about. Just a second. Last class I had trouble with this pen. I hope I don't have this problem this time. Okay. Thank you for your love. Acha. This is the mathematics convention. Oh, sorry. Chi. Mathematics convention, this will be dependent, right? And this will be independent. Do we all agree?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Maths convention. Okay, now, if we... When is it? Okay, now, I'm drawing a straight line. What is the slope? Mathematically, the slope depends on what angle is it creating with the independent axis. What is the slope here?
90 degree.
With which axis? With axis?
X-axis.
Is the independent axis, right? Thus, the slope is 90 degree. Is that clear?
Right, sir.
Okay, now, if I do the same thing again, over here. Then what I say, where's the colors? Now, Y is the independent axis, as we know in economics. X is the dependent axis, as we know. And we are saying that this is the econ convention. Okay. Now, what is the slope of this line with the independent axis? Quarter degree, 0 or 90? Isn't it parallel to the independent axis?
Yes, sir. 0, sir.
Yes, sir. 0, sir.
So in that case, what will the slope be in economics convention?
What?
No. Infinity can be why? 0 will be.
0.
This is 0 degree.
0 both, sir. 0 both.
With independent axis, which is now y under economic convention. Okay. Thik ache? Is it clear now? If it's not clear, I'll explain myself again. Look at the maths convention. The slope of a straight line depends on what degree is it inclined to the independent axis. So if it is inclined at 90 degree with the independent axis, which is where the independent axis in mathematical convention is x, slope becomes infinity. We are very familiar with this because this is how we have been growing up ever since we started to look at these slopes from class 7 or 8 or whatever. Huh? But in economics, we are making the y the independent axis. That is a same line ta. Okay, independent axis is parallel na? So it is 0 degree, right? Yes?
Huh? Yes, sir.
So that's why it is now 0, slope is 0. Here it is 0 under econ convention. Here it is infinity under maths convention. Acha, ekhon amra, let us see. This is 0. Why? Under the mathematical convention, x is the independent axis. This straight line is in parallel to the independent axis. So it is creating a 0 degree inclination. And thus the slope is 0. But if this was a economics text, tale ki ekhane 90 degree tori korbe na with the y axis. Can you see the cursor? If y is the independent axis, tahole ei straight line ta ki y axis is the 90 degree korche na?
Yes, sir.
Yes, does anybody?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In that case, in economics, when you see a line like this, elasticity will be infinity. If you are obsessed with a mathematical background, tomar first morning korba jare ki byapar, this is a slope ta howa uchit chilo 0. So why is it saying that this is an infinity? Eki bhabe perfectly inelastic demand curve dekhecho na? Do you remember one of your teachers showing you a perfectly inelastic demand curve like this?
Yes sir.
If you are obsessed with mathematics, then you will, the first thing you will say that kire the eta slope to 90 degree, so how can it be zero elasticity? It's zero elasticity because it's creating 0 degree with the y-axis, which in economics is the independent axis. Got it now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, lovely. So now we come to the main topic. Before we start this topic, I should ask a question. Does anybody have any questions on what we've covered so far before we get on to the next part? Does anybody have any questions? Does anybody have any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. Then I'll, since you guys don't have any questions. Acha. We start demand and supply. We have done these things in the undergrad, all of us, whatever our background is. So basically, demand and supply, when we see a demand curve, do we see one point or we see a connection of few points? When we see a demand function in a graph, this demand line, is it one particular
collection of
points?
A collection of points. If it was only one point, then we could say at this particular price, this is the supply, this is the demand, right? And there's nothing, no change. But when we present it in a graph, then we are showing a Sanchar path, the locus of some points that are moving. So I'm moving it as a demand curve. So there's a point over here, price quantity relationship. There's another price quantity relationship here. There's another price quantity relationship over here. So what a demand function or a supply function actually shows is, if this was the price, how much do we expect to buy or how much do we expect to sell if we are a producer? If this were the price, how much do we expect to buy or expect to sell? Then in essence, demand analysis is actually our desired rate of purchase. So if we look at the blue, this blue demand function, এটা কি একটা পয়েন্ট নাকি অনেকগুলো পয়েন্টের মানে প্রেজেন্টেশন এখানে দিস ব্লু ডিমান্ড কার্ভ ডাউনওয়ার্ড স্লোপিং ইজ ইট শোইং অনলি ওয়ান পয়েন্ট অর আ কালেকশন অফ পয়েন্টস সেম থিং উইথ দিস ইয়েস সাপ্লাই ইজ শোইং পয়েন্টস ফ্রম দিস পার্ট আপ টু হিয়ার ওকে সো ওয়েন উই প্রেজেন্ট আ ডিমান্ড অর সাপ্লাই মডেল basically what we are doing, we are showing a desired rate of purchase. That means if the price was over here, how much will all the households in the market demand? If the price is here, how much will they demand? If the price is here, how much will they demand? The similar analysis goes for supply. What's the planned rate of sales over here, at here, at here? So in economics, we are obsessed with the concept of equilibrium. Those of you who have come from a business background, have you noticed that whenever they teach demand and supply, they always tell you about equilibrium? You remember?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So because the theoretical development of the subject has been such that economists have been obsessed with the concept of the equilibrium. Now, equilibrium means batkharata erokom hobe, tai to? যদি না থাকে তাহলে কি আইদার ইট উইল বি দিস অর ইট উইল বি দিস এর বাইরে আর কিছু থাকবে ইফ আ ব্যালেন্স ব্যালেন্সেস দেন উই সে ইটস ইকুইলিব্রিয়াম ইফ ইট ডাজন্ট ব্যালেন্স দেন ওনলি টু পসিবিলিটিস ক্যান হ্যাপেন আইদার ইট উইল বি লাইক দিস অর ইট উইল বি লাইক দিস এর বাইরে আর কোনো পসিবিলিটি আছে
স্ক্যাটার্ড কি থাকতে পারে স্যার
স্ক্যাটার্ড না
আচ্ছা আচ্ছা
মানে
তাহলে নাই স্যার
If this is demand and this is supply, if they balance, they'll be like this. If not, demand will be more than supply or supply will be more than demand. No, sir.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If at the market price, The price has been declared, everybody knows. People are demanding more than what is being supplied. What will happen to the market price ultimately? Will it start to go up or it will start to go down?
Market price, barbe.
Barbe, very good. A common sense
bapar. Yes, sir.
This is the market price. People are demanding more than what is being supplied. For example, during festival time, the number of bus tickets, the number of launch tickets, the number of train tickets are not enough for the demand. Demand only beshi hoy na?
Yes, sir.
That's why a black market comes up. No matter how much we say that, you know, kalo bazari this and that, it's a natural phenomenon. The number of launch seats, bus seats, and train seats, and even plane seats, they're fixed. But the demand for those seats are much, much higher. So that naturally during the festival time, the price goes up. Another thing is, if at the market price, there is oversupply, what will happen to the market price? So the first analysis that we look at in demand analysis is, what happens to equilibrium if the if there is an imbalance between demand and supply? When we say imbalance, either demand greater than supply hobe or vice versa, supply greater than demand hobe. So ei jinish tai the first things that we look at. Egli kono kaje ashe na jibone jodio, but nevertheless, AJ, if this is the market price, 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 then demand is more than supply. Oh, sorry, supply is more than demand. So firms have a tendency to reduce the price. If this, if the price is very low, then demand is more than supply. So price tends to go up. So one of the first things that we learn is, when there is shortage, price goes up. When there is surplus, price goes down. And when there is equilibrium, price remains unchanged. The next thing that we learn is that the demand function that we see is that one person's demand or the demand of all the households in the market. Whenever we have whenever you have been presented with a demand function, was that demand function the demand function of one particular household or all the households in the market?
One particular.
All the households.
All the houses of the market.
All the households, because when you saw the demand model, you saw the demand for say Coca-Cola. Okay, so the Coca-Cola company is looking at the demand of the market. So the Coca-Cola company will definitely not look at the demand of one household. It will be looking at the demand of many households. Tanya?
Yes, sir. Right?
So supply khetro hota hai. Now, so when we are looking at demand and supply, we are basically looking at summations. Aggregate summation of all the households' demand, aggregate summation of all the supply of all the firms. Thik ache? So basically what we are looking at is we are adding up everything. Now, this is fantastic if everybody's demand is the same. This is fantastic if the sellers have the same type of technology and etc. Reality te keta hoy. Can we expect that all the sellers will have are equally can be equally treated?
No, sir.
Sir.
We can we expect that all the households can be equally treated? That no, we can sir. Just come up like that. So this is one of the greatest problems and limitations of demand and supply analysis. And this is why we go to other markets and find out what happens there. This is where the concept of matching markets will come into play. Jeta amra ei semester amra dekhanor chesta korbo. Thik ache? So for example, you go matching market means the supply is tailor-made to my demand, or if not particular my demand, tailor made to a very small niche market. Niche market is concept to shobai tai na?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
niche
no,
market. Oh, you have said no, sir. Hi, yes.
No, sir.
Acha Jubair, niche market means basically when a coffee shop is presenting coffee, do they make it for everybody in Dhaka city, or they make it for a particular clientele?
They are making everybody for Dhaka city who will come to their coffee shop. They will eat, they will drink that.
If I'm selling coffee at say 150 taka per cup, do you think anybody will come to my shop?
No sir, not everybody.
Not everybody.
Niche marketing is basically I'm targeting a particular group. This is called niche marketing. Niche is just a French word, which means that I'm targeting a particular group. In reality, when we calculate the demand, we never calculate the demand of the entire market. We calculate the demand of our target group. So if I am selling coffee at 150 or 200 taka, there are lots of outlets that do that in Dhaka city. They're not selling it for the entire 2 crore people of Dhaka city. They are doing niche marketing. They are targeting a small group. Ever clear? So yes, these sir. Are that, we are going to break in the next few. When we are talking about the market demand for say Coca-Cola, we are talking about the demand for Coca-Cola by 20 million people in Dhaka city, right?
Okay.
Now, if I am selling Coca-Cola in a restaurant, am I targeting 20 million people?
No.
I'm targeting a particular clientele. I'm targeting a small target group, right?
Yes.
So this is called niche marketing. Similarly, tea is sold everywhere in Dhaka city. It's sold on the street where the target group is 20 million people.
No, never.
Because even if I'm using a tong, okay, and I'm selling it in front of the Brack University at Mahakali, am I targeting the entire 20 million people of Dhaka city? No, I'm targeting a few hundred people in that particular locality, right?
Yes, sir.
So what happens is when we are looking at the demand and supply models that we have in the undergrad, they target the entire population, which theoretically is fantastic, which practically is not a good thing to do. And actually, we don't do that. That's why we have lots of types of markets which we will be coming up across. For example, monopolistic competition. For example, oligopoly, for example, monopoly, etc. Okay, sir. And why are these markets different? What is the characteristics of these markets? How can business executives understand the characteristics? We will be breaking this, but the main thing is that we don't target the entire market. Okay?
Yeah, okay, sir.
Okay, now let's see what we have after here. Acha. Another thing that we have is, this is how we present a demand function. The quantity demanded of X, whatever it is the function of the price of X, function of a substitute good, function of a complementary good, function of an income. It is the main variables. These four variables mainly determine the demand for a commodity, that the commodity's own price, the price of related goods. Related goods is defined, related goods is divided in two ways. They can be substitutes. How do we define substitutes? If X and Y are substitutes of each other, the relationship will be X or Y. Do we consume both at the same time if they are substitutes?
No.
So if we say that two goods are related to each other, then there can be only two possible options. Either we consume one or the other, then they become substitutes. The relationship becomes X or Y. Another possibility is we consume them together. For example, milk and tea, or tea and sugar. We consume them together. So what is the relationship between X and Y? Then it becomes X plus Y or X and Y. Clear?
Yes, sir.
So, and another thing is income. Income determines the demand for a particular good. because again we are doing niche marketing. The income of people in Dhaka city is not uniform. Some people have a high income, they demand a certain type of goods. Some people have a low income, they demand a different type of goods. So substitute goods, as we have said, is you see, X and Y are substitutes, then either X or Y. This is the relationship between substitute goods. If they are complements, then X and Y. Okay. So, and with income, we cannot say that just because our income increases, when our income increases, the demand for certain goods increase, we call them income superior. At the same time, the demand for certain goods fall, we call them income inferior. That's it. Some textbooks call them normal and inferior goods. So we'll use the word income superior and income inferior. So that what happens, as income increases, demand for some goods increase, for example, high-end mobile phones, and the demand for some goods decrease. Then our demand for lower-end phones will fall. Aren't there any other factors? Of course there are. But when we model something, we keep the models as simple as possible. Acha, ekhane tale ki, if your income has increased, then your demand for something will either increase or decrease. Fair enough? Do we agree on this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So if our income increases and our demand for, say, high-end mobile phones has increased, what happens to the demand? Demand ta dam dike shift korbe na?
Yes, sir.
Okay. If it shifts to the right, then it's a horizontal rightward movement in a graph. A horizontal rightward shift by definition means an increase. A horizontal leftward shift by definition means a decrease. Right?
Yes, sir.
Whenever we visualize something as horizontally, left to right, we are programmed to read as an increase. Right to left, we are programmed to read as a decrease. Tale, in undergrad, when we did a basic economics course, as the demand function moved from this black to this blue, increase hoye geche na?
Yes, sir.
It remained unchanged, but for some reason, our demand for that particular good has increased. This can be because our income has increased, our demand for high-end products has increased. This can also be because now that during the pandemic, our demand for online products has increased, right? Pandemic samay ki online market bere geche na, people can't go out, okay, and they were very much discouraged to move. So the online shopping industry boomed during the pandemic. That's why we saw a rightward shift. And we have also said that any horizontal movement to the shift to the right is an increase. Eki bhabe, during the pandemic, one industry suffered a lot, and that is some particular service industries, for example, hotel industry, tourism. Tourism to suffer korechhe na during the pandemic?
Ji, sir.
Because yes, people, sir. People could not move, they have to stay in Dhaka city. So normal time hoy ta ekta chuti paoa geche 3 diner. People used to go to, say, Cox Bazar, people used to go to, say, Silet or Panchgaur, whatever. So because people could not move, so what happened? The demand for those particular industries during the pandemic, they decreased. So there was a leftward shift. So next, what we are going to look at, what causes an increase in demand from a practical point of view, what causes a decrease in demand from a practical point of view. By addressing demand, we will also be addressing supply. What causes an increase in supply from a practical point of view? What causes a decrease in supply from a practical point of view? And what happens ultimately to the price? One of the biggest limitations of demand supply analysis is lokjon ekta chobi eke dicche tai na, je this price demand dam dike shift koreche, so equilibrium price goes up, quantity increases, tai na, ebong thash thush kore ebhabe graphs ekeche na, Acha. Do prices and quantities change just like that? Or they take time to change? Only in Hoyna. If the price goes up, it goes up slowly. Demand and supply also responds slowly. So what we are going to do is we are going to look at these things from a practical point of view. In the undergrad, you might have seen it with what do you call it? Just up down quotes, etc., etc. This is happening overnight. In reality, it doesn't happen overnight. It happens over time. For example, let me give you an example. When the pandemic started, how much were you paying for a mask? Were you paying a very high price?
Yes, sir, very high price.
When it started,
whatever the price was, it was definitely much, much more than what you were what you pay now, right?
Yes, sir.
Why? Because initially, some farms could take advantage of this high demand, which happened overnight, and they could respond to it. So what happened? They made some super normal profits. But will this super normal profit be sustainable?
No.
Over time, other people saw that there's a demand over here. Then they started to develop their capacity. So what happened? Slowly, the price came down, right?
Yes, sir. Supplies increased as well.
It's increasing, but this supply increase will happen over time. It doesn't happen overnight.
Right, sir.
These are the things that we're going to look at from the next class, that practical point of view, what happens if when demand increases or decreases, or what happens when supply increases for whatever reason, or supply decreases for whatever reasons, okay? And another concept that we are going to look at is demand elasticity. Have you heard of demand elasticity? Elasticity of demand?
Yes, sir, but kind of forgot the entire thing.
You'll forget, don't worry. It's quite natural not to forget. We can remember because we practice these things a lot. Elasticity means how quickly or how slowly can we respond to a change. If we take time to respond, then businesses have one kind of signal about the behavior of the consumers. If consumers can respond very quickly to a change, whether that is a change in price, a change in income, what caused the change doesn't matter. But if I can respond very quickly, my elasticity will be high. If my flexibility or responsiveness is restricted, then my elasticity will be low. Let me give you a very simple example. Tomorrow I have to go to, right now I have to go to Chittagong. Now it's 7:45. I have to be in Chittagong by 12 o'clock. So if I go to the plane, airport, and the airport plane tickets are 3,000 taka more, will I argue?
No.
No,
sir.
Because I am not in a position to be flexible. I have to go to Chittagong right now. And the only way I can reach there very quickly is by plane. This thing happens during festival times when people who buy tickets at the last moment are people who are less responsive to changes. Even if they want, they can't. But if somebody is buying a ticket, say, 1 month in advance, 1 week in advance, won't they be flexible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
If you look at the pricing of air tickets, you will see that if you buy at the last moment, they charge a huge amount of money because they know very well whoever is going to buy at that particular moment is less responsive to price. This is elasticity of demand. They are less elastic. And at the same time, somebody who's planning a vacation 1 month later, they're more flexible. They're more elastic in their responses. So they will respond to price very easily. Another person will respond to price less easily if they're buying at the last moment. So what is elasticity of demand? How does this particular behavior influence business decisions of firms. This is what we will see from a practical point of view. Okay?
Yes, sir.
So whatever you learned in the undergrad, you learned it, maybe you've forgotten it, no problem. But now what we'll try to do, we'll try to look at practical examples of the demand and supply that we discussed, and elasticity of demand, which we will be introducing next week.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. But just a second. Okay. So does anybody have any questions? Any questions? No questions so far?
Yes, sir.
Somebody said yes, sir. What question do you have?
Sir, I said yes, sir. You asking me no questions so far? I said yes. I don't have question.
Oh, yes means you don't
you
have.
You don't have. Yes, sir.
Sri Lanka. In Sri Lanka, this means yes, and this means no. You know that? Have you been to Sri Lanka? In Sri Lanka, this means no, and this means yes.
Sir, I have a question, sir.
Hi, please.
Sir, it's are we going to follow any textbook for this course?
Textbooks, because we do have the texts over here. See, where is it? Ajay, this was today's reference. Okay, so and the page numbers are also given. You look at this thing, but the thing is, when I'm going to ask you to do an assignment, for example, the assignment that you did, assignment number one, I'm very happy to tell you one thing, that most of you, well, probably all of you, wrote in your own language, right? On your own.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The question was intentionally designed so that you write your own story.
Right.
Number one. Number two, once you feel confident that writing your own story in your own words, your plagiarism index is very low, then you get confident to write on your own in assignment two. Right?
Yes, sir.
So I don't know about the second, the other section. Your section, I checked the plagiarism just 15, 20 minutes before the class I finished. Very time consuming. So most of you had plagiarism index of 0, 1, 2, and 3%. So that means clear indication, almost everybody in the class wrote from their own words. There were a few people whose plagiarism level is 8% or 10%, but even that is not a problem. That is due to paraphrasing. I will explain in, once I give back the assignments, I'll explain how to reduce even that. Okay?
Okay, sir.
So, yes. I'm very happy that most of you, but plagiarism index is a good indicator that you guys wrote your own story, right?
Yes, sir.
Right.
Yes, sir.
So, in assignment two, you'll get an incentive to write your own story again. Come on. So, since the system has to try to make you work on your own. Also, any other question?
স্যার আমার লাস্ট কোশ্চেন ছিল যে বইটা ফলো করব ওই বই থেকে কি স্যার যে ম্যাথ স্কুলা তো সব স্যার ওই বই বুকের রেফারেন্সে তো স্যার ফলো করব এই গ্রাফ স্কুলা
আই আই উইল জাস্ট স্টিক টু দোজ টু বুকস
ওকে স্যার
ঠিক আছে কারণ হচ্ছে কি ওই বেশি বই ফলো করলে যেটা হয় কি পিপল গেট কনফিউজ
এক্স্যাক্টলি স্যার এক্স্যাক্টলি
দ্য থিং ইজ উই ওয়ান্ট টু বি অ্যাজ প্র্যাকটিক্যাল অ্যাজ পসিবল উই ওয়ান্ট টু লার্ন সামথিং হিয়ার
এক্স্যাক্টলি স্যার রাইট স্যার
এনি আদার কোশ্চেন
Thank you, sir.
Anybody? Acha, one person asked me a question at the beginning. I mean, what is the last day of the demo? Question to Mule, see. Say, Bhadra Mohila ki ache?
Sir, wasn't it about reverse?
Acha, what was it about? Can you say it again?
Sir, reverse function related ki chota chilo?
Reverse function, acha. The question was that that person very good acha inverse function er byapar ta hocche marshall put price on the vertical axis marshall was from cambridge there was another gentleman his name was john hicks he was from oxford so whatever cambridge does Oxford has to do it differently. Okay, Higgs stuck to the mathematical convention. All analysis of price is always on the horizontal axis. Okay, sir. So there was this very famous textbook, mathematics textbook, written by an author called Alpha C. Chiang. So আমরা যখন এটা পড়েছিলাম তখন আমরা দেখি যে কি রে প্রাইস ইজ অন দা হরিজন্টাল অ্যাক্সিস সারা জীবন দেখছি যে প্রাইস ইজ অন দা ভার্টিক্যাল অ্যাক্সিস তখন আমরা জানলাম যে দিস ওয়াজ আ লিটল ডিবেট ইউ নো আর প্লাস হলো আরেকটা একাডেমিয়াতে একটা প্রবলেম আছে ইফ ইউ গো টু প্রফেসর এ এন্ড আস্ক অ্যাবাউট প্রফেসর বি প্রফেসর এ বলবে আরে বি তো কোনো লেখাপড়াই জানে না হ্যাভ ইউ নোটিস দিস হ্যাঁ
So real life দেখি নাই বাট থিওরিজের সময় দে কন্ট্রাডিক্ট ইচ আদার অনেক বেশি
কন্ট্রাডিক্ট আর একটা আরেকটাকে ওরা অত করে লেখাপড়াই জানে না সো দিস ইজ হোয়াট দিস ইজ ইফ ইউ স প্রাইস অন দ্য হরিজন্টাল অ্যাক্সিস ইউ ডিড নট সি রং ইটস বিকজ অফ দিস লিটল ডিবেট বিটুইন মার্শাল হু পুট ইট অন দ্য ভার্টিক্যাল অ্যাক্সিস ফ্রম কেমব্রিজ অ্যান্ড হিগস হু কেপ্ট ইট অন দ্য হরিজন্টাল অ্যাক্সিস ম্যাথমেটিক্যাল কনভেনশন ইটস জাস্ট আ ভিজুয়াল প্রবলেম দ্যাটস ইট আর কিছু না ওকে The person who asked the question, the inverse.
Sir, economics to shop shomoy price ke, I mean shop kichu price in terms of price kore na.
In terms of price kore, and that's how the analysis started. But after some time, people found out this analysis is too simple. That's why you know pore porobortikal aro mane ki bole modified hoyeche shop kichu. Price is used as a signal, but in real life, it's not a good signal. For example, nowadays, is your CGPA a good signal in the job market?
No, initially it is, but nah.
Actually, it's not. Nowadays, employers are more interested in what skills you have.
Yes, sir.
Right now, but what kind of experiences can you show?
Yes.
So, economics so tai initially price was a very good signal. After some time, as time went on, economists realized that it's not a good signal. Job market ho tai, 30 years ago, people who had came out from Jahangirnagar University, North South and IBA with good CGPA from a business school, they got very good jobs. Ekhon 3.9 POK, can you think that you'll get a good job?
No, sir.
So
আমার মনে হয় সবকিছু এখন সিচুয়েশন বেসড হয়ে গেছে
সিচুয়েশন বেসড হয়ে গেছে বিকজ কম্পিটিশন হ্যাজ ইনক্রিজড 30 ইয়ার্স আগে কম্পিটিশনটা ছিল না তাই না
ইয়েস স্যার
সো ইফ ইউ আস্ক ইওর ড্যাড ইফ ইওর ড্যাড অর ইওর আঙ্কলস আর বিজনেস গ্র্যাজুয়েটস ফ্রম 30 ইয়ার্স অর 25 ইয়ার্স আগে তারা বলবে হ্যাঁ আমার তো 3.9 ছিল 3.8 ছিল না আই এম এ বিগ শট বাট রাইট নাও ইউ গো আউট ফ্রম উইথ 3.8 3.9 অর ইভেন এ 4 আউট অফ 4 দেয়ার ইজ নো গ্যারান্টি দ্যাট ইউ উইল গেট আ গুড জব তাই না
স্যার
ইয়েস স্যার এই সো ইকোনমিক্স এর ইয়াটাও তাই যে দ্য পারসন হু সেড দ্যাট এভরিথিং ইজ এক্সপ্রেসড ইন টার্মস অফ প্রাইস ইয়েস সিম্পলিস্টিকলি ইয়েস বাট ইন রিয়ালিটি উই সি দ্যাট দিস থিংস নিড টু বি চেঞ্জড ওকে
ইয়েস স্যার
ওকে এনিবডি এলস এনি আদার কোশ্চেন শুড উই স্টপ ইট হিয়ার
ইয়েস স্যার
ওকে সো হোয়াট আইল ডু Today's slides you can already get in the Google Drive. I uploaded it after the Saturday class. Our aajke class er je video ta it will take some time, but once it's done, I'll share it in the Facebook group. ঠিক আছে?
আচ্ছা স্যার একটা কোশ্চেন ছিল।
হ্যাঁ শিওর ক্যারি অন।
স্যার কমপ্লিমেন্টারি ডিমান্ডের মধ্যে আমার আমি যদি কফি খাই তাহলে আমার সেটার সাথে সুগার লাগছে।
Good question. Over time, yes, at the particular time, no. Yeah, sir. Over time, yes, because the thing is, you see, the cause and effect, when we look at it, we look at it from an analysis that other things are remaining unchanged. For example, if you go to a kidney doctor, you have some problem with your kidney, what will the doctor assume? That your other main organs in the body are working all right, right?
Yes, sir.
This is the first assumption that the doctor will make. Economists' analysis also starts like this. Economists know very well that price is not the only factor that determines demand. but they want to isolate the effect of price on demand. Similarly, they want to isolate the effect of a complementary good on demand. They want to isolate the effect of income on demand. Now, when we look at the isolation of income on demand, we assume everything else is unchanged. This is a simple model. Kidney doctor tai korbe. You go to the kidney doctor, you're having trouble with your kidney. The doctor will assume that your other major organs in the body, your heart, your blood pressure, everything is all right. You're not a diabetic patient. Initially, assume korbe na?
Yes, sir.
So these are simple models. In reality, these models will not hold. That doesn't mean that the models can be rejected. They teach us something. But once we realize they need to be modified, we look at it from a more mature point of view or a more practical point of view. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, lovely. Any other question? Shall we stop sir, it here? Oh, yeah, carry
sir,
on, please.
Video, sir, YouTube, or the answer?
Hi, YouTube, or the
answer?
Bye, sir.